When looking at people in power, there seems to be a sea of men who are making the most important decisions in the world. But things are definitely changing. More and more women are being represented in politics and working their way to the top, changing the political landscape. In today's video, we are taking a look at the history of women in politics and the current most powerful women in the world. Hello and welcome to another KYC Lookup video where we bring you AML related content to help you enhance your knowledge in the fight against money laundering. Before diving into today's video, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on any future videos. Oh, and don't forget to leave us a comment with any suggested topics you would like us to cover in the future. Okay, so let's get going. Women have played an integral part of political history. And so it may come as a surprise that since the early 1900s, women have been involved in politics making important decisions. The first woman we are going to take a look at is Margaret Grace Bonfield. Margaret worked as a shop assistant and was so appalled at the conditions of workers that she became a member of the Shop Workers Union, which led her to then co-found the Women's Labour League in 1906. In 1928, she was one of the first of three women to be elected as a Labour MP, first for Northampton and then for Wall's End. She was also a very strong supporter of the women's suffrage and became the first woman cabinet minister and the first woman privy councillor. Next we have Jacinda Ardern. Jacinda Ardern is the Prime Minister of New Zealand and has been since 2017. Jacinda began her career in politics, working as a researcher in the office of Prime Minister Helen Clark, and then later moving to London, where she worked within the Cabinet Office and then was elected President of the International Union of Socialist Youth. She was first elected as MP in the 2008 general election, when Labour lost power after 9 years. Since her time in power, Ardern has made many positive changes, which includes her plan to halve child poverty within a decade, increase parental paid leave to 26 weeks, increasing how much you are paid within that time for low to medium income paid families, increase minimum wage, and introduce the Provincial Growth Fund to invest in rural infrastructure projects. When Christchurch was hit with a terrorist shooting, Ardern threw her arms around the community and brought in tougher restrictions on people owning semi-automatic firearms and assault rifles, and along with Emmanuel Macron, brought together the church and tech companies to work together to tackle the ability to use social media to promote terrorist extremism. Next up is Angela Merkel. Angela Merkel is the current Prime Minister of Germany and has been since 2005. In 2007, Merkel served as President of the European Council and played an integral part in the negotiations of the Treaty of Lisbon and the Berlin Declaration. She also played a central role in managing the global crisis and the European debt crisis. She negotiated a stimulus package in 2008, which focused on the infrastructure spending and public investment to counteract the Great Recession. Merkel has also put into place future energy development, with a plan to phase out nuclear energy in Germany, reduce the country's greenhouse gas emissions, and increase renewable energy sources. In 2014, she became the longest-serving head of the government in the European Union, and as a surprise to everyone, in 2018, Merkel announced that she would be stepping down as leader and would not be serving a fifth term as Chancellor in 2021. And finally, we have Kamala Harris. Kamala Harris has been catapulted into the spotlight in recent months, as she has just become the first woman to become Vice President-elect in the 2020 US elections, which puts her at the highest ranking female elected official in US history. With that being said, Harris has been involved in politics and law for a number of years. In 1990, Harris was hired as a deputy district attorney in Alameda County in California, where she was described as an able prosecutor on her way to the top. In 1998, San Francisco District Attorney Terrence Hallinan employed Harris as an assistant district attorney. Whilst there, she became the chief of the Career Criminal Division, where she supervised five other attorneys. There, she prosecuted over homicide, burglary, robbery, and sexual assault cases. In August 2000, Harris took a position at San Francisco City Hall, working for City Attorney Louise Wren. Harris ran the Family and Children's Services Division, representing child abuse and neglect cases. Wren endorsed Harris during her DA campaign. In August 2020, Joe Biden announced that he had chosen Harris as his nominee for the vice president position. And as of November 2020, she became the first woman to become vice president-elect of the United States of America. As you can see, women have played major roles in politics all across the world and are making a real difference. Other women that are also making positive waves in government are Nicola Sturgeon, Erna Solberg, and Nancy Pelosi. So, there you have it, our list of women in politics. Tell us in the comments section which other ones should have made the list and why. Thank you for watching the video. And if you made it this far, don't forget to like and subscribe to watch more amazing videos.